All right, on to a new topic, still related to, or back again to electromagnetism. We're going to talk about transformers. And no, not More Than Meets the Eye. It's not Transformers the movie or the toy or whatever. We're talking about transformers that convert voltage, all right, or EMF. So typically, if you live in a country other than the United States and you want to use something that was made in the United States, the voltage of that thing is going to be 110. Probably the country that you're in is 220 or 230 or maybe 240, something like that. In the Philippines, it's 220. So if I want to use any device that's from the U.S. in the Philippines, I need a transformer to convert the voltage. Otherwise, I'm going to fry my device. So some typical examples of transformers, you might have seen these in your neighborhood up on a power line, power pole near the power lines. This is a very heavy-duty transformer that converts voltages in power lines. This is an AC adapter for, say, like a laptop or something like that. Inside there would be a transformer. And then this is what's called probably an AVR, automatic voltage regulator. And inside there would also be a transformer. So those are just what they look like on the outside, but of course we're interested in what they look like on the inside. So let's talk about that. Alright, so here we have a diagram, simplified, of course, of what a transformer looks like on the inside. Zoom in on that, and we're going to have to talk about how it works as well. So this part of the transformer is very important, and this is one reason why it's extremely heavy. I mean, most transformers are pretty heavy, and the reason for that is this guy. This is an iron core, a soft iron core. So that's very important because, as you might recall, iron is a temporary magnetic substance, so it is able to have its magnetism changed easily based on the magnetic field that's produced near it, and it'll just transmit whatever magnetic field is produced through itself. So this is an iron core that goes in the middle of the transformer. That's the basic part. It amplifies the magnetic field that's produced by these wires. So what's another part? Well, you have what's called the primary input or primary winding of the transformer, and then you have a secondary winding of the transformer. Your alternating current comes in on the primary side and it goes out on the secondary side. All right. So I mentioned that it's alternating current. I'll talk about why that is in just a minute. But of course you can see it's coiled here. There's a coil of wire, and then it comes back out. This coil of wire is going to produce a magnetic field when current is flowing through it. If you hooked this up to direct current, it would just set up a stable magnetic field, and you'd have like a north end here and a south end here maybe, and that would be it. So you'd have a north pole, and that would be transmitted over this way. So I guess this would be a north pole here, and that would be a south pole. In any case, probably. I don't know that for sure. Actually, more likely this would be a north and that would be a south. But in any case, the point is you would set up a magnetic field and then it would sit there, all right, if you used a direct current. That wouldn't accomplish much. As you recall, a current produces a magnetic field. So, but also, a changing magnetic field can produce a current. So it's the two sides of the coin. Moving charges or current produce a magnetic field, and moving magnetic field can produce current or moving charges. So on this end, we have current coming in from our power supply, which would be like plug into the wall, basically, what's called mains voltage. So I just added that in there, mains voltage. Basically, that's what comes out of the wall. And then that's going to go into this primary coil, and it's going to cause a magnetic field to form. Now, the reason you need AC current, you might remember alternating current constantly changes its direction, like 60 times per second. So at one moment, the current is flowing, say, downwards through the coil and out, and then the next moment, it's going to be flowing upwards through the coil and out. So 60 times per second, the pole of the magnetic field that's set up by this coil of wire is going to flip 60 times per second. So at one moment, it's north end here, south end here. At the next moment, north end here, south end here. Next moment, north, south. It's flipping constantly. That sets up a changing magnetic field in this iron core called a magnetic flux. So this magnetic flux then is going to transmit over to this coil of wire, which is sitting here, not connected to a power supply, but it's coiled up. So if this magnetic flux passes through this coil of wire, then it's going to be switching back and forth. That's a changing magnetic field. It's the same effect as if we moved this coil of wire physically through a stable magnetic field, which is what we do with a generator. We actually move this coil of wire inside a stable magnetic field, but in a transformer, it's the magnetic field that is changing, and the coil is stationary, but the same effect, basically you get the same effect. You get, because the magnetic field is moving through this, or the lines of force of the magnetism are moving through this wire, it's going to cause a current to flow. So the amount of current will depend on the number of turns of wire, and the amount of voltage as well, which we will talk about in the next video. But basically, you need alternating current in order for this to work, because you need a changing magnetic field, not a steady one. Direct current would set up a steady magnetic field, and that does us no good, because then there's no change. No change means there's no current flowing, and nothing happens. So you need alternating current, because the magnetic field then is constantly changing, flipping poles constantly, and that's going to cause a flux through this wire, magnetic flux, and that magnetic flux will cause a current to flow in this side. All right, it's a bit complicated, but hopefully that makes sense to you. I said it several different ways and several different times, so I'm hoping that that makes sense. This is the symbol for a transformer, and in this case, it would be a step-down transformer, which is what we have here, because there's more coils of wire on this side than there is on this side. Step-down, we'll talk more about that in the next video. Here you can see an AC adapter that's been opened up. This part right here is the iron core of a transformer. Here you've got your plug outlet for your input mains voltage. And then you got some interesting stuff up here. And we're going to talk more about that because I really wanted to revisit this topic after discussing diodes in video 81. So we're going to do that right now. Okay. So what we have here is we're revisiting this diode rectifier bridge that we talked about in video 81. And it's basically a bridge of four diodes that that cause the output to be direct current when the input is alternating current. So if we have alternating current coming in, basically, I'm not going to go over all this again. You can watch video 81 again if you need to, but this part of the output will always be positive, and this part will always be negative, even with an alternating current, because of the diodes. So that's the main idea in review of what a diode bridge does. Schematically, what we have going on in this AC adapter is you've got a transformer. It's hooked into the diode rectifier bridge. The diode rectifier bridge is also hooked up to a capacitor, and that's all hooked up to the load. Basically whatever it is you're charging, computer or cell phone or something, or powering whatever the device is that requires this AC adapter, right? Now check this out. Right here, diode, 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 four diodes, and a capacitor. So that is super awesome. Four diodes, a capacitor, and a transformer. So what do they do to the voltage? Well, let's look at that. Okay, so here we have the diagram of the diode rectifier again, the AC adapter right here in its entirety. You start with input from the wall, which gets transformed, still alternating current, however, so it's going to look like this, sometimes positive, sometimes negative. The diode rectifier bridge is going to convert that voltage pattern into this one. It gets rid of the negative and makes it all positive. So No backwards current anymore, but it's still going to bounce from zero to a positive value, and then back to zero into a positive value, and then back to zero into a positive value. That's not ideal. You don't want your current to oscillate between a maximum and zero when you're powering a device that runs on direct current. You'd rather have a more smooth voltage, and that's what the capacitor is for. Because of that capacitor being in there, when the voltage tries to drop to zero, the capacitor fills in the gap, and then the voltage comes back up again and recharges the capacitor, which then discharges as the voltage tries to drop, the capacitor fills in the gap, and you get a smoothed out voltage curve thanks to that capacitor. So this is what an AC adapter does for you. It takes alternating current from the wall and it changes it into a smoothed out direct current like that, using a diode rectifier bridge and a capacitor and a transformer. That is super cool. So this has been your introduction to transformers and also just a bit about the diode rectifier bridge that we talked about previously. So that's it for this video. In the next video, we're going to do some calculations with how you actually like figure out what's going on numerically with a transformer, and that'll wrap up transformers for us. So just two videos about this topic. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.